Hello, everyone. During this time of quarantine, Sue and I really miss the choir and the joyful voices of the congregation singing hymns. So we've been thinking of ways we can do something a little extra to reach out to everyone at St. Mark's and also to anyone who'd like to share this. We are calling it Hymnology. That's hymnal plus knowledge. So what we're going to do is Sue will tell you a little history about a popular hymn that we all sing together here at church, and then she will accompany me singing that hymn for you. One thing we've learned over the years here at St. Mark's is people love the hymns. So we hope you enjoy this. Let us know what you think, and after today, maybe you'd like to hear more. We sure do miss everyone, and we can't wait till that Sunday when we're all back together again.
The first hymn we have chosen was written by Thomas Obadiah Chisholm, who was born in a log cabin in Kentucky. He became a Christian at age 27. Throughout his life, his health was very unstable. Through all the ups and downs that Thomas faced, he discovered new blessings from God every morning. The third chapter of Lamentations became precious to him. Lamentations 3:22. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Thomas sent the poem he wrote based on this scripture to his musician friend, William Runyon, who was so moved that he prayed earnestly for special guidance in composing the music. This beautiful hymn was published in 1923.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, my compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever wilt be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter, springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars and their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy
She felt led to become a missionary in her teenage years. In 1880, she went to South Africa to begin her service. It was there that she wrote, "'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus." In her later years, she and her husband served as Methodist missionaries in Rhodesia. There she wrote, "Our connection between the face of these peculiar difficulties, I can't help but say, who is sufficient for these things? But with simple confidence and trust, we may and do say, our sufficiency is of God." George came to Christ through the ministry of the Salvation Army. Later on in his life, he was ordained by the Methodist Episcopal Church and became a traveling evangelist. George realized he needed to better understand the power of the cross of Christ. He later said, "I was praying for a full understanding of the cross. I read and I studied and I prayed. The Christ of the cross became more than a symbol. It was like seeing John 3:16 leave the printed page. While watching this scene with my mind's eye, the theme of this song came to me." It took several months for the words to formulate in his mind. As he preached through the Midwest, George would carry the words with him, working on them, polishing them, and singing the melody over and over in his head. Finally, in 1913, this beloved hymn began appearing in hymnals all across America. So I'll change.
dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. In that old rugged cross, stained with blood so divine, a wondrous beauty I see. For 'twas on that old cross Jesus suffered and died to pardon and sanctify me. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true, its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
So I hope you enjoyed this. Let us know what you think, and we'll come back and maybe we'll post some more. Thank you very much.